Alright guys, if you're just jumping in here, I'm trying to get some action. Heads up on this wonderful Saturday morning. We'll see if Funky Crime, I think is his name. He may or may not give us some action. He prefers 6 max and he knows I'm a heads up player, so he sometimes plays heads up, but he'd rather... Yeah, let's start 6 max instead, so... Yeah, he's good about it though. Like some guys just hit and run or quiet. Like he'd rather start a full table or a 6 max table, right? Which is not a bad thing. Like heads up, it's I'm either better than you. Or you're either better than me or you're gonna lose money, right? Like, 6 max, it lets, you know, quite a few fish sit at the table too. It's just, I think this is my strongest game. And I like all the action, trying to figure out when third pair is good, fourth pair is good, all that good stuff. I'll play 6 max, it's just, you know, it's kind of yawn, kind of boring. Alright, well, here's the 6 max. Wait for our big blind. So, the site that I'm playing on is PlayNow, PlayNow.com, a Canadian site between three provinces, BC, Manitoba, and Quebec. They just had a software update, so I don't mind the user face here. It's okay, but a lot of changes. There's no more HUDs allowed on the site. I had all my stats and everything all nicely organized, tracking every hand with Poker Tracker 4, but can no longer do that. The instant replay is atrocious. I can't hit instant replay yet because I haven't played a hand. Yeah, so they like it's an improvement for sure, but there are some bugs to work out. Like in the instant replay, like if we both go all in preflop right now, it goes all the way to showdown, there's a winner, right? In the replay, it should show both hands. It doesn't show what my opponent has. I'm like, how is that even possible? Like all the money went in, it went to the showdown. Maybe you can muck in real time, but in the replay, it should show both hands. Like it's ridiculous. I think King High is good here actually. Gonna float. He might have just turned to 4. I don't have much money in the site. Just like $1,200 or something. Messing around. And it has an auto top up feature. And that's why you saw me go to the cashier and hit top up. It is this little button here, auto rebuy. But it's not like Poker Stars where it's 50 cents, top up, 50 cents, top up, lose $4, top up. It tops up if you're one penny short of whatever your settings are. This waits till you're like $6, $7 down and then does it. It's like, it's really weird. I don't get it. Just auto top up means if I don't have the maximum that I can bring to the table, top it up, please. That's what I would interpret it to mean. But like I said, they have some weird glitches, but it's Canadian, like supporting Canadian site. The players are quite soft. So. We are also sitting, if you guys can see, like I'm still sitting an open Omaha heads up, don't fold. Oh, I've taken him for rolls. Small stake stuff, but like $400 or $500 off of him. I don't feel like playing Omaha. Asking. Like I said, the site's good, but I mean, in the heads up realm, you're gonna get 4 or 5, you know, average players that once they learn that you're a decent player, they're not gonna wanna play you. And then you've got the really, really tough guys that move up in stakes to like, you know, once you're past 1-2, 2-4, 3-6, 5-10, they sit 4 or 5 open tables with 6,000-7,000 just sitting there waiting, right? Waiting for someone to play. So it's tough to get action at heads up. If they know you're good. Let's See, my, yeah, and there's no presets. Like, you know, on some sites you have presets, like third of the pot, half pot. I guess, well, they have some, but I would rather have different settings or custom settings, which I think is just a nice feature. What else can I share with you? I want to fold this off to the side here. Like, so let's say we get action heads up. Depending on the stake, you want to know what am I going to 3-bet to, and it depends on your opponent's opening size. If he's min-raising, what size do you 3-bet to? If he's 2.5xing, which size do you 3-bet to? If he's 3xing, which size do you 3-bet to? So you can't see it on this screen, but like, I'll pull it into view here. Hopefully you guys can see that. I have it kind of off to the side. It's just good. It's a guide. I already know them, but I mean, it doesn't hurt to have. But 50 and L or 25 cent, 50 cent, it's called 50 and L. If he's min raising or 2x open, go to $4. 2.5, you go to 450. If he 3x's, 550. Same thing at 100 and L. You know, if he min raises, go to 8. If he 2.5x, go to 9. If he's 3xing, like he makes it $3, you 3-bet to $11. And so then 200 and L, 400 and L. And then when you want to bet the flop, you can see they're all the same. You usually want to bet around 55% on the flop. It's a good size in a 3-bet pot. Turn 66%, and then river 66 or shove or whatever. But I have this pulled off to the side at all times. Very handy. Just you need to know your sizing. And then actually over here, you guys take a look. This is my heads up. I don't know if you can see the tabs at the bottom for heads up. Oops. Same thing. So like I was saying, if he's min raising, you want a flat 70%, 3-bet 23. And this is a nice polarized 3-betting. Here's all your value, some middle of range, and then your trash or your 6-2 suited, all that sort of stuff. Versus 2.5x, you can see we play a little bit less, 57 and 22. And then versus 3x, you have to tighten up your range and adjust a little bit. So you're here, you're playing like 61% versus a 3x. Versus a min raise, you're playing 93%. So you can see how the you tighten up as the sizing gets bigger, right? And then I have this Excel spreadsheet off to the side, which is super handy and nice because third-party software usually gets picked up. You can't have that anymore, like PokerStars, all that stuff. They have software that detects any third-party software being running in the background. But an Excel spreadsheet that you put all these hours into to build, you can have that running. They can't tell you to not use that, right? So what do I do? What do I do facing a 3-bet? Well, is he a super tight 3-better? Like, has he only 3-bet twice in this whole match? Or is he 3-betting every other hand, right? So here's your default, but let's say he's really, really loose. Okay, well, 3-bet your premium for value, or 4-bet your good hands for value. Flat all the green. Mix in some 4-bets with your offsuit wheel aces, because I think the wheel aces suited have better playability. And then mix in some funky 4-bets here. So, really cool chart. And I have one for 6 max, which will... here, I'll go back to the action here. I opened a hand. Got backdoor equity. We like 5, 7, diamond. That is good, but it pairs the board. You could have a 10. Usually it's not good to barrel when the board pairs, especially the middle card, because he called with a piece, which means he might just have trips now. Or he could just have a 10. I think he checks a 10, bets a 4. Interesting. Oops, sorry, I hit the mic there. I don't know what he would lead out with here. Alright, maybe he bets 4. I hit fold and show. Why did it hit fold and show? Did I not just hit fold? Oh, it's probably because I clicked on those. My bad. Did not want to show my hand. I look like a tool. I had 8 high. Oops. Alright, so we've flopped like the biggest draw possible. Now this could go either way. Either I think it's just too strong. Too strong to raise. We have enough equity just to flat. Now we can hit a 3. Oh, he's betting so fast. What do you have, like... Of course it bricks out.
losing count. Never understood how we carry on. I guess we just learned how to do without, like,
all in or fold. Yeah. That's just annoying. Here, see, that's what happened. I went fold in a show. I didn't need, I'm so used to clicking on them. Whatever. Doubled. Yeah, I haven't played with him. We'll find out. We're gonna watch. Life is tough, kid, lighten up. President flirting with genocide. Get deported if you ain't white enough. Please take longer. It's great for the game. Players love the excessive tanking. Preflop for under a dollar. Pretty tough decisions preflop, huh, guys? Limped pot. Take some time. Think about it. Drives me nuts. I understand tough decisions in big pots, but preflop, the decisions are fucking animated at this point. I don't even have to think. I know position, raise, fold, call, who's in the hand. Like, it's just, it's automatic. It's like breathing. But whatever this bullshit is. Oh, you checked. All right, I'm going to limp. No tanking preflop. Post-flop, yes, the dynamics change. Yes, the strength of hands change. You have some things to think about. Pre-flop, it's like, fucking go. Position, check, raise, fold. Like, whatever. Check, bet, fold. Like, fuck off. You're pissing me off with your tanking for under $1 decisions. What do I do with my hand here? I've posted early in the cutoff. Let me hit time bank. Fuck out of here. Yeah, so back to my other sheet here. So I have it for 6 max too. Now this took me like over 40 hours to make. I know this one's a little off-centered when you first look at it, but you can see under the gun, what do you open? You're opening all of the blue 100%. And if it's a softer game, optional, you can open those ones. Under the gun plus one, now you're opening 20%. Cutoff, you can see 26%. A button, you're opening 40% plus optional 13% of hands, depending on how soft your opponents are in the blinds, right? You want to kind of make a few adjustments there. So all of this, and then in the small blind, I have a mixed strategy where if it's a weak opponent, I would say just raise to 4x and attack. If it's a sophisticated, good opponent, you can't just always do that. They're going to play back at you. They're going to 3-bet you. Because now it's just you versus them, and they're going to have position on you. So you need to have a mixed strategy for your small blind with a competent opponent in the big blind. So I kind of blend it. I have still open raising in all the blue. Definitely limp calling in the green. Jacks, queens, kings, and aces. You can either just open raise or limp re-raise. And then it's good to have a limp re-raising range in the small blind as well in the pink here. There's a mixed strategy which helps you stay unpredictable and still yet kind of like profitable against a competent opponent. And then verse second category here, versus raise first in. RFI stands for raise first in. So let's say I'm in the cutoff. Okay, I'm in the cutoff and under the gun open for 3x. What do you do? Well, here, you call these hands, your value is here, and here. Actually, we got a good example. Let's see. So I'm under the gun. I opened with 6-6 and I got 3-bet by the button. So let's go back. All right. I'm under the gun versus 3-bet. Under the gun versus the button. We call with our 6-6 right here. There's a cool chart. These rangers are from Upswing Poker. I did subscribe. Bought two courses. So two courses plus the Upswing Lab, the monthly lab. So the Heads Up Mastermind course, loved it with Doug Polk, thought it was fantastic. And then I bought another one, the 6 Max course, which with Educa Poker, Andreas, I can't remember last name. We might be ahead here. He checked back, so he can have aces, ace king, ace queen, brick, ace 10. Would have fired, so he doesn't have ace 10 because all 10s fire on this board. Get a pocket 10. No, pocket 10s would have fired as well. Three bet, ace 8, 3 bets. Queen 10. Bet's pretty big, but there's a lot of draws on this board too. Interesting river. So we still beat Ace King and Ace Queen. All the draws missed. Either you had it or you don't. He could have aces and it's a scary flop, so he checked it once. Now he's not worried about aces. Worried about it. It's taking this long. That's really interesting. Aces bet for sure. Kings bet for sure. Queens bet for sure. Ace, I think aces, kings, and queens all bet the flop, though. At least once. And assess the turn. Check the flop, bet the turn. Could have ace 8 suited, though. A very interesting spot. I just haven't played with him enough to know if he's capable of doing it with nothing. So that's my my sheet that I made. There's it goes like the line items go all down to like line 1200. But yeah, so you have your raise first in, what do I open? What do I do against someone else's open? And then what do I do against a 3-bet? So these are all the ranges, and it's just open on the side at all times. So if you want to play really good poker, like these are your ranges, but you make adjustments based on how the game's playing a little bit and everything as well, right? So got king queen on the button. Let's take a look here. Versus a limp. Fucking terrible. So I like... Some guys still do 3x. I go... No, my opening range is normally close to 3x. You could do $4. I like doing $5 for the limper. Another old school guide would be like... You were going to open a 3x. So do 3x. And then one big blind for every limper. So that would technically be $4. I just put another blind in. Really disincentivizes anyone else to come along unless they have a really strong hand. I'm gonna bet half pot again. Yes, there can be an ace, but not too worried. 5-3. Do we open 5-3? Let's take a look. Take a look at our ranges. In the cutoff, 5-3 suited. Oh, we open it. Now I go to 250 or 249, I don't know. I would say, now this sounds terrible and is very predictable, but if you have two strong opponents, so like red tags, which are shark or whatever. If you have red tags or strong opponents, I would say open smaller because you give them less incentive to attack or 3-bet your blind because there's not as much money in there. If you... have weak opponents in the blinds and you're opening and you're in position, I would say make it 3x. Build big pots against these weaker opponents and they're super loose, right? And they're going to overcall with weaker ranges. So I do make it like 3x when I see two green tags in the blind. Is it obvious? Yeah, it's obvious, but whatever. Good players know what's going on, but they're not in the hand, so it's not really a big thing. Really? Really? Oh, I'm yawning. I got one of these going on. I really was hoping play heads up. And a dollar went. Others. There's only two tables of six max right now. And we're waiting. Actually, what I'll do is I'll just for action's sake here, I will I'll sit 50 in L. It's really, really super small. Get action. Great. All right, so we got 50 in L. 50 in L is 25 cent, 50 cent. Got 100 in L. And then we'll mess around with a 6 max. 50 cent a dollar just for now. And this lovely Saturday morning. Well, dude, how do you like this hair? Oh my. But like clay, like the styled it last night when I fell asleep. It's all like stiff. Yeah. Got a little, the little mohawk. I had a mohawk way back when. Popularized by Chuck Liddell. I had the short little one stripped down the middle. Strong limp. Okay, what does that tell us about this player? In the cutoff. Just earned himself a green fucking tag. No problem. And type today. We're just going to write limping. So these are... See how I'm making that note really quick? I had... hundreds of these, like every single player on the site pretty much. And you're like, what? How can you have every single player? Well, you got to keep in mind, this is a small Canadian site with 3 provinces. All right. It's not like PokerStars, which is enormous international, where there's 200,000 plus or 100,000 plus players at any given moment. On any given moment on this little site, maybe 1,200, probably closer to like 500. It's not hard to like put notes on, you know, 400 or 500 players after you've been playing quite a few hours over what, a year or two, so it adds up quick. The old King Jack. King Jack in the small blind, what do we do? Okay, well let's take a look. What do we do against a button open? So versus raise first in, we are in the small blind against a button open for about 2.5. King Jack off. Really? We raised that? Alright. We'll do it. What if it was 3? Small blind versus button open for 3. It's still a raise? Very interesting. We get 4-bet. I like his sizing though. 4-bet, usually you want to go 2.5x the size of the 3-bet. All right, you got me. All interfold with the King Jack. We tried. I didn't think King Jack off was, interesting. King Jack off, small blind. Yeah, small blind defend versus button open for 2 big blinds, we raise. For 2.5 big blinds, we raise. 3 big blinds, we still raise. Jack off in the small blind. I guess that makes sense, though, right? Because if you come back to, like, your raise first in, look at the button's range. The button is playing over 50% of the hands. King Jack offsuit, I guess, has to be better than... You know, it's well ahead of his opening range, because if he's playing 50% of the hands, King Jack off ranks pretty high, I mean, amongst all the other shit, right? So... And that's the other thing, like, versus a raise first in, so anything out of the small blind. Small blind is really, yes, especially out of the 3x. You'll see there's very few calling hands out of the small blind. Small blind plays mostly raise or fold. Reason being is you're out of position. If you flat call the person in the big blind, you open yourself up to getting squeezed. Squeeze meaning they can, you know, now the big blind can maybe raise both the button open and your flat. And then now if the button calls, now you're like stuck in between, you know, the button and it's a shitty situation all the way around. So you want to be the aggressor. The small blind play is pretty much fit or full, raise or fold for the most part. That's why you don't see too many calls. I guess you see calls when it's a min open a little bit more. All right, so we got a hand here. We're going to open it up. I'm not going to bother. Most of this table is green tag, so I'm just going to open to 3x now. I'm not even going to bother with the 2.5. There's not a lot of bad players. Good flop for hand. Half. 75%. This is where I usually have my presets. I have a $300 Corsair K95 keyboard. You guys see that? Is that possible? Fancy schmancy. So, like, all these are what's called macros. I actually program them. So macros, basically, I will go into my software for the keyboard. The keyboard has software, and I will type in, like, I usually like going 66%. It's a good number where, like 75%, 80% sizing for the pot. You're going to fold out all the hands that you're ahead of anyways. Like, maybe you bluff, but you're only going to, you shrink their calling range, and what they're going to call with is really, really strong, right? So you want to pick a size that allows them to float, allows them to draw, and keep some of those weaker hands in that you're beating, right? So a third of the pot is too small. Like, on paired boards, it makes sense because it's a way ahead or way behind spot, but a third of the pot most of the time is too cheap. Everything's going to call. And if you went 80% or 90% pot, it's too expensive. Only the strongest part of the range is going to call. 55% can be an argument. I like 66%. I just think it's a really good number. So, because, like I said, they don't have the presets built into their software. So I accommodated or countered by using my fancy keyboard, and I would use a macro where I go into the software, I hit record, and then I will type in, like, Let's say if it was the pot was $10, right? I want 66% on the flop, and I know the stakes that I'm playing, so I would put 6.6, hit stop record, and it remembers the sequence of keys that I typed. And then I assign it to one of my hotkeys. So now every time I press my hotkey, it just types in that sequence of numbers. That's what a macro is. So instead of me actually going over to the keypad and going 6.6, I just hit my hotkey, and it instantly goes 6.6, right? On these flops, especially on three, like a monotone board, I like a third of the pot here a lot, whether I have it or don't, and I do it a lot. And then I usually do a half pot bet on the turn. You can check raise with a naked king of clubs, obviously, like king 10 with king of clubs. Most guys check it back a lot. I like betting a third of the pot on monotone boards. Not a good turn card. Unless he had pocket eights or pocket twos, in which case we would have to represent. He's still gonna call a turn to try and pair the board. But it's more likely he had a naked king of clubs. Really? Maybe it is. Or ace two, ace eight. Very interesting. Well, that removes a ton. King of clubs. Down at the 10 of clubs. He has to have the king of clubs or nothing. Thank you. Holla back. Like I said, he's good, he's creative. What kind of notes do I have? 3-bet pot, 10 king 6, he'll float jack 9. He floats every gutter, 3 bets, 5x from a small blind. Bends king 3 to a button open. He bet check bet that board with queen queen. Which is a really good bet on the river, because there's an ace showing. He 3 bets with 9-9, doesn't see bet. 9, 8, 7, 10, 10. I have ace jack, obviously, because I rivered a straight. Oh, I was... What did I have? 4, 2. But... Checks back aces on 10, 7, jack. 4, 9. But calls a river pot size bet. Hey, I tried bluffing on this board. 10, 7, jack, 4, 9. These are the kind of notes I have. Like, you guys need to take really good notes. Because you want to know what a player is capable of, right? So that's why he's red tech. Like, he's thinking. He's a thinking type of player. And willing to, you know, make moves, take shots. These guys are just fit or fold. Like this guy, I don't even, he just sat down. I have no idea who he is.
We're just gonna go fish. Why did you not buy in for the full amount? Doesn't make sense.
You know it's French. Pain, pita. Je peux parler en français aussi, si vous voulez. Pain, P-A-I-N, or pain, pita. Pain is the English word. Pain. Now, if I'm not mistaken, it's been like 20 years since I spoke French. But pain means bread. I think. French. I think. Let's find out. Look it up right now. Pain. French word for bread. French word for bread. Look at that shit. Look at that shit. Pain. So, you know that guy is from Quebec, right? You'll see a lot of guys typing in French, speaking in French at the table. Oops, sorry. Because they're from Quebec or Montreal. And the other thing about French is it doesn't translate well word for word in English. A lot of times the context of the sentence or the phrase can be translated, but if you were actually to translate word for word and try and keep it in order, it wouldn't make sense. In French, it's reverse. Like here, I'll give you an example. For his name is Avatar. What I want to say is this is pita bread, right? Pita bread is probably the way we'd say it in English. You wouldn't go, hey, do you have bread pita? No, do you have some pita bread? But in French, it's pain pita. Like, it's backwards. A lot of things you'll notice in French are backwards. But here, I could use my mixed strategy, but I would do it probably against a better player. So I'm just going to open raise and attack. Like, we could have gone, Alright, ace-king offsuit is what we had. So right here, I could have mixed my strategy. Could have limp re-raised. But I don't like limping against an opponent who's just like, I limp too. Like, good player in the big blind, he's going to be aggressive. He's like, fuck that limp. I'm going to raise 4x. And then he's going to try and build a pot and play a bigger pot in position and try and take it down. That's the whole point. So, I don't want to waste Ace King with a limp with a shitty weak player that's probably going to just check it back. And then the flop comes crappy. So, I lean more towards just open raising with a weak player in the big blind. And then I'm more willing to limp or trap against a good aggressive player in the big blind because now I have some moves. I can limp re-raise, I can flat call, but it's just, it plays better, I think. To limp some of them against good players, but just to open raise against players. Anyway. This music is like too hardcore right now. Don't get it twisted, I ain't perfect in the least. I'm still all up in your girl jeans like a crease. You know what I feel like? Where's that Nirvana song? This one. Sorry guys, no action at the heads up tables. I wanted to do a little video, but hey, at a minimum, it's a little insight into the PlayNow site. And you can see this is literally how I set up. Spin. Oh, that looks funny. Feet on the table. Some would say it's a little too relaxed. Sit up straight and focus. I am focused. I have everything set up properly. I've got my two monitors. You can see the game. But yeah. Anyway. Yeah, when I play online, like I am focused. Like I said, I've got everything up and running. I've got all my ranges, and I know most of them. Ranges change for live, big time. These are six max ranges and heads up ranges for online poker. But those online ones for Heads Up, I've been playing with them for 2 years straight now. Like, I know them pretty gosh darn cold. And when I go to play live, it factors in. Like, if it's small blind versus big blind, button versus big blind, like, those are some of the most common spots. Like, button open, big blind defend. Like, I'm just thinking, oh, I have a heads up spot, heads up ranges right now. And I just instantly shift to, like, I know we're at a full table, but it's just me and you. My heads up ranges kick in, and I'm like, I'm 3-betting this, 4-betting that. Yeah, that seems like a reasonable size to 3-bet. Do you guys 3-bet 5x? Makes no sense. And in position, nonetheless. He's out of position. I don't think I can fold. Alright, versus 3-bet. Versus 3-bet. Let's go take a look here. I was what? Under the gun, and I got 3-bet by the small blind. Under the gun, way over 9. I'm supposed to fold. As a loose call. This is way too loose a call. He's 3 suited, yeah. Under the gun open, facing a 3-bet from the small blind to 9 big blinds. He didn't go 9, he went 15 fucking big blinds. Ace 3 is a definite fold. You know what, I'm gonna barrel him off his equity here. Or barrel him off, I think. A size up for a river shove. Okay. Easier. Sorry, oh, you guys didn't see that. I'm talking about, whatever. Let's see the shitty instant replay I was talking about. You even see that? I was not supposed to call. What's up? Oh my god, Celine. I had a fun hand against Juwan last night at the tables at Club Region. This exact hand. We've been talking about 4-betting ranges and maybe 5-betting ranges. Some of the hands that you can use for value and as a bluff. Everyone loves the ace 5 suited. Or even offsuit. I almost like ace 5 offsuit better as the 4-bet. Ace 5 suited just plays so well as a call. It has more equity. Anyway, king queen is another, same thing. King queen offsuit is another hand that could go either way because you block pocket kings and pocket queens. And ace queen and ace king. Yes, your opponent can still have them, but it's just a little bit less likely that they do because you have a king and a queen in your hand, right? There's only so many combos of kings, queens, ace king, and ace queen, and if you have one of each in your hand, it removes the likelihood of it being in your opponent's hand. And that's all poker is, small little edges. So I'd opened yesterday, we're playing 2-5 with a straddle to 10, and there was a call, so I'd opened a 30 and a call, and Juwan made it 200? And I thought about it, and then I just ripped it in for 1,000. And he tank! And he was all right, he was close. He tank folded, but, and then I showed the king queen because we had just talked about that hand, so. Turning it into a bluff. I like the king queen in a bluffing range, some percentage of the time. All right, I think I'm gonna call it, but, never going to fold 8s, 7s, 6s. King high calls a lot, though. King jack there, maybe. King queen there, maybe. I can get those hands to fold. All right. Anyway, I'm going to sit out this next hand here. And I just want to pull up this freaking instant replay. Like, see how hard that is to see? I know. So, I'm not supposed to call this $15. What a ridiculous 3-bet size. I can understand 4x, which is 12, or 3.5 maybe, to like 11 or something. Like, 12, 15, 5x 3 bet. And then I should have ripped it or folded, I guess. It says it's a fold for my ranges, but I have such a hard time with my suited wheel aces. It goes check, check. And he checks again, which means he probably has ace king or ace queen. Like any big pair, tens, jacks, queens, kings, aces are betting, pocket eights are betting, pocket nines are betting. Like every big pair, and especially with one spade, is all betting. And when he never does, I said, I tried to size up because I'm like, how much is the perfect river shove? It's 29 in there. If I bet 17, that makes the pot roughly 60, and then I can bet 50 left into 60. So I was trying to find the right number to size up for a perfect river shove. So I bet 17, and he just folds. Anyway. All right, I'm gonna call it there, and that's enough enough poker for this morning. Just messing around, but there we go. Yeah, yeah. I was hoping for some heads-up action because it's just so much more involved, lots more to see. I would have kept it on the one screen most of the time, talking about the different hands, the spots, being super aggressive, lots of three betting, lots of four betting. Lots of all-ins, lots of bluffs, but no action first thing this morning. So anyway, hope you guys have a wonderful Saturday, long weekend. And yeah, we got a big fun game lined up for tomorrow, hosting a poker game in the afternoon, a 2 p.m. game. Hopefully lots of action. Hopefully it runs really long. Stacks get deeper the longer you play. Players bust or need to go. Maybe we can get fresh blood in the game later in the night. So should be a good one. Looking forward to it. But yeah, that's it for me, guys. All right. I'm signing off. Peace. I got to find the stop recording.